Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. Donald Trump is about to start his first official visit to Britain and brushed off mass protests over his red carpet stay, saying, "I think they like me a lot in the UK, they're great people." The US president will meet the Prime Minister and Queen in a four-day visit and is minutes from landing at Stansted Airport with First Lady Melania. Already waiting for him in the UK are up to 1,000 of his own staff and a giant motorcade led by his bomb-proof Cadillac nicknamed the Beast, as well as multiple helicopters. Earlier today he gave an extraordinary press conference in Brussels after giving NATO leaders a bruising over funding. When asked about the threat of mass protests he said, "I think it's fine. A lot of people like me there. I think they agree with me on immigration. I think that's why Brexit happened." Protesters have pledged to follow him wherever he goes in Britain and 10,000 police officers have been drafted in to protect him, the largest number deployed since the 2011 riots. Anti-Trump campaigners have promised he will face a wall of sound wherever he goes, urging supporters to take pots and pans from home and bang them because they believe he is sexist and racist. Despite not being an official state visit, the government is desperate to ensure the US leader feels he is being treated with the appropriate level of pomp and ceremony. He will be treated to a guard of honor when he meets the Queen at Windsor Castle for tea tomorrow. There will also be a grand dinner at Blenheim Palace tonight, Winston Churchill's ancestral seat, as well as a lunch with Theresa May at Chequers on Friday. Tonight he will stay at the US Ambassador official residence in Regent's Park, London, which has been surrounded by a ring of steel of new security fences and road barriers to prevent a terror attack. On Saturday he will fly up to Scotland to play golf at one of his resorts and his son Eric landed in the family's Trump Force One private jet at Aberdeen this morning, before flying to Helsinki to meet Vladimir Putin on Monday. Donald Trump speaks in Brussels after forcing NATO members to up their spending by $33 billion ahead of his trip to Britain today and shrugged any fears he had about mass protests, saying, "Britons like me a lot." His entourage also includes a giant convoy of cars including his bomb-proof vehicle, the Beast, which is also bomb and chemical weapon-proof, which was also guarded by Britain's top armed counter-terrorism unit, CTSFO. Armed police are patrolling a new security fence now surrounding the US ambassador's residence in Regent's Park. Police are also guarding barriers installed at Blenheim Palace near Woodstock, Oxfordshire, where Donald Trump will dine this evening. Trump's helicopter Marine One and a squadron from the US Marine Corps were waiting for him at Stansted today. Days of protests are planned for the Donald's visit, including a march through central London tomorrow and everywhere he is visiting. Days of protests planned to welcome Donald Trump to Britain. Donald will be accompanied on the trip with Melania, pictured together yesterday, and the First Lady will be given a tour of London and attend a charity event. Protesters plan to follow Donald Trump everywhere he goes in Britain over the coming days. This includes a Stop Trump march through central London set to involve 70,000 people. Here is the US President's itinerary and the protests planned. Today 1 p.m. Stansted Airport as he arrives on Air Force One. 3 p.m. at Winfield House, the US Ambassador's residence in London. 7 p.m. protests at Blenheim Palace. Friday 11 a.m. protest outside Chequers during Trump's working lunch with the Prime Minister. 2 p.m. tens of thousands will march from Portland Place to Trafalgar Square in central London. 5 p.m. outside Windsor Castle when he meets the Queen. Saturday all day, protests outside his Balmedy course in Aberdeenshire and at his Turnberry resort in today. The US president described Britain as a pretty hot spot right now with a lot of resignations and suggested his meeting with Vladimir Putin in Helsinki on Monday could be easier. And he made clear that he did not approve of the softer stance the PM has been advocating despite fury from many Tory MPs. "Brexit is Brexit, the people voted to break it up, so I would imagine that is what they'll do, but they might take a different route. I'm not sure that's what people voted for," Mr. Trump said, adding, "The great people, I just want them to be happy. The EU better be careful. I warned them. Immigration is taking over Europe," he added. It seemed as if the UK was getting at least partially involved back with the European Union. "I'd like to see them be able to work it out so it could go quickly," he said. Protests will culminate in a 70,000-strong march through London from Portland Place to Trafalgar Square. The Stop Trump march is part of a wider carnival of resistance across the UK while he is here. Other protests, including several family-friendly gatherings, will take place at every place he will visit over the coming days. The Capitol's Mayor Sadiq Khan has allowed a group to fly a giant balloon showing Mr. Trump as a baby in a nappy over the Capitol during his visit. Nearly every force in England and Wales has contributed officers to help with the massive mobilization, the biggest since the 2011 riots. The US president arrives after giving NATO leaders a tongue-lashing in Brussels over defense spending and controversial comments about Britain being in turmoil. He said he got along with Theresa May very well, but suggested he might make time during his UK visit to speak with his friend Boris Johnson, who has just rocked her government by resigning as foreign secretary. It was up to the people whether or not they want Mrs. May to stay as prime minister, he added. The tight security surrounding the visit will attempt to avoid exposing Mr. Trump to planned protests in central London. His schedule involves a black tie dinner at Blenheim Palace tonight with US and UK business leaders and cabinet ministers, hosted by Mrs. May. Ahead of his arrival, the PM said she would use the visit to forge a strengthened, ambitious and future-proof trade partnership with the US after Brexit. Donald Trump met up with Theresa May in Brussels yesterday and is heading to the UK for 4 days for an extraordinary and controversial visit on Saturday. He will fly up to Scotland to play golf at one of his resorts, and his son Eric landed in the family's Trump Force One private jet at Aberdeen this morning, pictured. Activists from Stand Up to Racism Scotland, SUTR, are already outside at Trump Turnberry Resort in South Ayrshire, ahead of the US president's arrival in the UK. Trump's giant motorcade has been racing around London over the past few days, pictured, for his visit to Britain. This giant and controversial Trump balloon showing the world leader in a nappy will be flying over London this weekend. Mrs. May said there is no stronger alliance than the special relationship between the two countries, and there will be no alliance more important in the years ahead. Hailing the two countries' uniquely close partnership in the fight for democracy and global security, she also pointed to our unrivaled trade and investment relationship. She added, "This week we have an opportunity to deepen this unique trading relationship and begin discussions about how we will forge a strengthened, ambitious and future-proof trade partnership." Yesterday, Buckingham Palace announced details of the President's meeting with Her Majesty. The monarch will meet the American leader and First Lady Melania at a specially erected dais in the quadrangle of the historic Berkshire Royal Residence on Friday afternoon. A guard of honor, formed of the Coldstream Guards, will give a royal salute and the U.S. national anthem will be played. The Queen and Mr. Trump will then inspect the guard of honor together, before watching a military march past. The 1st Battalion Coldstream Guards is one of the British Army's longest-serving units. As well as an operational role, they also undertake a ceremonial role as the Queen's Guard, protecting the royal palaces. Afterwards, Mr. and Mrs. Trump will join the Queen for tea at the castle in her private apartments. Given the opulence of their own residences, they are likely to marvel at the surprisingly frugal life the British sovereign leads. No other members of the royal family will be involved in Friday's visit, something of a surprise compared to the welcome other major political leaders have received. The Queen, left this week, will meet the U.S. President and First Lady Melania Trump for tea at Windsor. Two Boeing C-17 Globemaster U.S. Air Force planes delivered part of the presidential motorcade at Prestwick Airport, South Ayrshire, ahead of the visit of U.S. President Donald Trump. Several Black Secret Service 4X4s took to the road with a police escort as part of the huge security operation. The President's motorcade, including enormous 4x4 vehicles, is pictured on the tarmac at Prestwick. Tomorrow morning, Mr. Trump and Mrs. May will view a mock counter-terror exercise involving special forces units from both countries. The joint exercise, at a secret military location, will involve the demonstration of high-tech equipment used by the SAS and their U.S. counterparts in joint operations. The two leaders will also meet U.S. officer cadets who are embedded with the U.K. military for part of their training. Separately, Melania Trump and Philip May are due to meet military veterans and schoolchildren at an undisclosed location. Among the firms attending are representatives of Diageo, the drinks company, McLaren and Arapin from the U.S. Blackstone Group and BlackRock Asset Management. After the Special Forces exercise tomorrow, the two leaders will travel to Chequers for the summit, which will also be attended by Jeremy Hunt, the Foreign Secretary. On the agenda will be Russia, trade, Brexit and the Middle East. A woman with a buggy pushes her child through the barriers at Regent's Park close to the U.S. ambassador's residence. Barriers used to prevent terror attacks are also being set up to protect Donald Trump during his visit starting today. After tea with the Queen, the President and his entourage will leave for Scotland, where he is expected to stay on one of his two golf courses. One of the biggest ever police operations will be staged to cover Mr. Trump's brief stay in the UK. Nearly every force in England and Wales has contributed officers to help with a massive mobilisation, the biggest since the 2011 riots. Thousands of officers will be on duty to cover the visit, during which President Trump is expected to visit locations including Blenheim Palace, Chequers, Windsor Castle, the US Ambassador's official residence in Regent's Park, London, and Scotland. When the Queen meets Mr. Trump on Friday, he will be the 12th US president she has met out of a possible 13, as she didn't meet President Johnson. Yesterday, the Mail revealed how Americans in Britain have been warned to keep a low profile amid fears of violent demonstrations during the visit. In an extraordinary alert, the US embassy urged its citizens to be on the guard around large gatherings that may become violent while the president is in the UK. He arrives after giving NATO leaders a tongue-lashing in Brussels over defence spending and controversial comments about Britain being in turmoil, as Theresa May's Brexit vision failed to convince all of her party. Mr. Trump, pictured right in Brussels yesterday, said Boris Johnson, pictured left leaving his London home yesterday, was a friend, and suggested he could meet up with him in the UK. The unprecedented warning was issued as businesses were told to prepare for protests. They are expected to be the biggest since the Iraq War, and organizers claim they could involve hundreds of thousands of people. The Queen has received three other U.S. presidents at Windsor Castle since the 1980s, Barack Obama in 2016, George W. Bush in 2008, and Ronald Reagan in 1982. Buckingham Palace has not confirmed how the Trumps will arrive, but it is expected that they will come by helicopter in order to avoid any potential protests on the ground, landing the castle's grounds and being driven by car to meet the monarch, 1,000 staff, helicopters, planes and his bombproof beast, the incredible entourage following Donald Trump to Britain. Donald Trump's bombproof limo has been designed to survive a military-style chemical warfare attack. Donald Trump will be accompanied by as many as 1,000 staff, a motorcade and multiple helicopters during his UK trip. Here is what the presidential entourage is made up of. Air Force One. The US leader will emerge from Air Force One, one of two specially modified Boeing 747-200s. The luxurious aircraft, carrying the tail codes 28,000 and 29,000, are highly customized and can act as a mobile command center in the event of an attack on the United States. The words, United States of America, the seal of the President of the United States and the American flag are all visible on the outside of the plane, making it instantly recognizable. The aircraft has 4,000 square feet of floor space, including a presidential suite with a large office and conference room, a medical suite that can be used as an operating room, and two food preparation galleys that can feed 100 people at a time. Overseas trips see additional staff and security flown over on an Air Force C-32, which is a modified Boeing 757. The Beast. The presidential motorcade, which includes two identical limousines, nicknamed the Beast, and other security and communications vehicles, is brought across by Air Force transport aircraft. The Beast is a 7-seat black armored limousine which reportedly cost $2 million, £1.5 million, and is designed to give Mr. Trump the ultimate protection. It can be turned into a sealed panic room with oxygen tanks, night vision camera and reinforced steel plating said to be able to resist bullets, chemical attacks and bombs. The Cadillac has Kevlar reinforced tires and steel rims that can keep the vehicle moving even if the tires have been destroyed. Bottles of the president's blood type are carried on board in case of a medical emergency, and a satellite phone enables communication to be maintained from anywhere in the world. As well as being able to defend the president, the car also features a host of attacking capabilities, such as a pump-action shotgun and a tear gas cannon. Marine One. A number of presidential helicopters, either VH-3DC Kings or VH-60N White Hawks, which are known as Marine One when the president is on board, are also brought on overseas trips. The Marine One helicopter is fitted with communications equipment, anti-missile defenses and hardened hulls. Staff and security personnel are ferried around in MV-22 Ospreys and CH-46s. Staff typically involved in an overseas trip include Secret Service post-standers, military communications specialists and White House aides. The president has at his side at all times a White House doctor and one of the five rotating military aides who carry the nuclear football, equipped with communication tools and a book with prepared war plans. There is always a group of 13 members of the press on such visits, including three wire reporters, two print reporters, four photographers, a three-person television crew, and a radio reporter. Prisoners get better accommodation. British police drafted in to protect Trump moan about being forced to sleep in a sports center with 300 stretcher beds, cold showers and no phone charges. Police officers drafted in to handle Donald Trump's visit to the UK have hit out of the disaster zone, accommodation in which they've been put up. Up to 10,000 police officers have been drafted in to protect the US president from mass protests and the threat of a terror attack when he visits Britain today. But pictures posted by police online show some have been given camp beds in a gym hall in Essex, while others have ground sheets placed on the floor of a squash court. Police drafted in to protect Donald Trump during his trip to London have been put up in this sports hall, with around 300 camp beds crammed in. Another picture shows mats put on the floor of a squash court for six other officers. Photos of the Spartan sleeping arrangements were shared by John Apter, chairman of the Hampshire Police Federation, which represents some of the rank and file officers brought from the South Coast. A police officer from the West Midlands shared this image of the sports hall where he is staying with scores of other officers. He tweeted, "Prisoners arrested last night will have had better accommodation than those police officers, ensuring the presidential visit runs smoothly. Police chiefs who talk well-being of their people need to take a long hard look at this. This is not acceptable." It is said around 300 officers are staying in the gym, with some complaining of freezing cold showers. One Twitter account said to that of an officer from Manchester said police couldn't charge their phones and were still sorting beds late into the evening. The National Police Chiefs Council said, "Some of the accommodation pictured today for officers supporting the major operation for the US presidential visit is not acceptable and below the standard of other accommodation for this operation. Essex Police is working at speed to resolve the issues for the affected officers." The West Midlands Police and Crime Commissioner, David Jamieson, said, "The conditions some West Midlands police officers are being forced to endure is an absolute disgrace. No officer should be made to sleep on a camp bed, inches from the floor, in a sports hall with scores of colleagues only meters apart after a 12-hour shift. Some female officers are even having to sleep in squash courts. These officers are in the southeast to keep the President of the United States safe. They aren't asking for luxury accommodation, but the least we can do is put them up in a room with a proper bed." Not all of the officers brought in were unhappy with their accommodation. Responding to the pictures, another policeman said, "Absolute disgrace. The first picture looks like we've been displaced after a natural disaster, and the second, sleeping on a gym floor. The organizers should hang their heads in shame. Once they get out of their nice comfy beds." It comes after chief constables around the UK cancelled rest days and told officers to prepare for being shipped hundreds of miles from home, under what has been codenamed Operation Manifold. Nearly every force in England and Wales has contributed officers to help with a massive mobilisation, the biggest since the 2011 riots. It is understood that other police officers being put up in places where the president is staying have been given hotel rooms, although the quality of accommodation is not the same for all. Hundreds of riot vans full of PCs will take to the streets today, tomorrow and to stop planned rallies and marches turning violent, particularly when they clash with supporters of the controversial US president. President Trump flies in this lunchtime and will meet staff at the US ambassador's residence in London before a business dinner at Blenheim Palace in Oxfordshire. The president will meet the Queen at Windsor Castle tomorrow before heading off to Scotland for a weekend of golf. Ahead of Trump's arrival today, the presidential motorcade arrived at Prestwick Airport in South Ayrshire. Two enormous US Air Force Boeing C-17 Globemaster aircraft were spotted on the tarmac before several Black Secret Service 4X4s took to the road with a police escort. Security barriers have been thrown up around the U.S. ambassador's residence, while security teams in Special Osprey aircraft have been seen practicing security procedures in the skies over London.